would start this evening. City of Bedford, council meeting November 15, 2021, City Concourse, 1402 H Street. Penny, would you please lead us in prayer?
I certainly will. Lord, we come today with grateful hearts for the blessings that you bestow upon our city. And we also ask you once again for your guidance, your wisdom, as we consider the issues at hand. We ask you, Lord, for the continued safety and well-being of those actively involved in the protection of our community. And we thank you, God, for all these things and more. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Calling the meeting to order then. All council members are present in person this evening. So, reading and approval of minutes for October 18, 2021 regular minutes. And adoption of memorandum for November 3, 2021 executive session.
I make a motion to accept the minutes in both meetings as presented.
Second.
We have a motion by Larry and a second by Ryan. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you. We will move on to old business. We have third and final passage, ordinance 22-2021. Additional appropriation for the police department. Is there any discussion on the third and final passage of this ordinance? If none, then I would entertain a motion.
Mr. Mayor, I would move for the third and final passage of ordinance 22-2021.
Motion by Brad and a second by Judy. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you. Number two, third and final passage, ordinance 23-2021, amending section 33.41D of overtime policy, establishes additional compensation for the city's canine police officers.
Motion to approve.
I heard a voice.
It was mine.
I'll be a second.
Okay.
I'll defer.
Okay. We have a motion by Penny and a second by Dan. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you. Okay. Number three, third and final passage, ordinance 24-2021, amending section 33.41 overtime policy for the emergency call-in. Any discussion? If none, then I would entertain a motion.
Make a motion. We approve ordinance 24-2021.
A second.
Motion by Ryan and a second by Larry. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Number four, third and final passage, ordinance 25-2021, establishing encroachment specifications for the street cut ordinance. Any discussion? If not, I'd entertain a motion.
Once, Mr. Flynn, I guess this is a question for you. Once we vote this ordinance in, then it's basically got a 30-day period until it becomes law per se. Will you be communicating with all utility companies? I mean, are we going to take billboards out, or what's, how are we going to fly a sign, or what are we going to do here?
Thank you for the question. We do have a list that I've compiled going basically, I went through all the underground call-ins for the whole holy moly type thing. I've just searched them all and looked, see who has been using that service and developed a list. And so I've got a pretty big list already that I'm getting ready to do a mailing to, and I'll mail the ordinance, the applications, that kind of thing. Let them know about the bond requirements and everything. So that should go out very soon.
Any other discussion?
If none, then I would entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion if we approve ordinance 25-2021.
Second.
Motion by Ryan and a second by Brad. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed?
I think this was a great stride, Mayor, on this. This was a big thing that's been an issue in the city of Bedford for years, and hopefully it'll make the streets last a little longer.
It's been an issue that we've worked on, and even by passing this ordinance, we've worked on it for several months, and we know that down the road we'll probably have to do some changes to it and look at it, but it's going to be something that's going to be in place for us to continue to work with, which I think will be a huge benefit, there's no doubt. Thank you. All right, new business. Ordinance 26-2021, amending ordinance 20-2021, salary ordinance. So with the salary ordinance, you can see some of the highlighted areas that's been looked at as far as to some updates. As you look at the salary ordinance itself, if you go to the second page, I just want you to make aware of it, because it is a change. Let's see here. About 1, 2, 3, about 4 down, the assistant plant superintendent. That salary was changed to $2,402. And then the prior salary ordinance, that position was left out and unfortunately was not changed, so that's an update. That is we have two employees that fall into that category, and they're both certified, carry their license to work at the wastewater plant and also the water plant on Illinois Street. So there's that notation. As you look through your salary ordinance, section 7, it is highlighted, and that has to do with the wellness testing for the city employees. So that was reworded a little bit from the standpoint of the point system. And then it was also, because of COVID issues, our wellness testing that was performed was a little bit late this year. And with Thanksgiving and Christmas, sometimes it's a challenge to get into their doctor to get the process done. So we extended that till the end of February to give the employees adequate time to get this done and get their paperwork turned in either to HR or to the clerk treasurer's office. For the savings, and then also you will notice on there that we did put in that if they don't follow through, because we're going to go ahead and give them their credit for January and for February, if they don't follow through with the process, then we will deduct that savings then out of their check for our reimbursement if they don't follow through with the procedure. Jill and everybody that's going to goes ahead and follows through with it, of course. But we just put this in there just as added to make sure that they get it done. And that thing is going to take place if it doesn't. There was one other location, section 14. Part of this was, unfortunately, of the old salary ordinance was left out. We looked at it, and part of it was somewhat inaccurate as to exactly how it works. So the police department and the fire department have an overtime / compensation line item that will disperse the monies to employees according to the guidelines set forth in the fire department and the police department SOPs for overtime and compensation. So therefore, each department will provide an SOP as to paying their overtime out. Each department does it a little bit, in the past has done it a little bit differently as far as how they work that. So we decided at this point to go ahead and let each department go ahead and do their SOPs as how they prefer for that to take place, and then go from there. And then also, by it being an SOP, if for some reason it needs to be changed, we won't necessarily have to redo the whole salary ordinance. They can just do the SOP and it'll go to the Board of Works, and then proceed from there. So that's what I've got highlighted. Marcia, do you have anything else?
I think that's all of it. It states all of that at the top of the ordinance to what sections we're in.
So is there any questions or discussions on ordinance 26-2021 amending the salary ordinance? That should be all of the things that I mentioned. And if there's not any discussion, then I would entertain a motion.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
I'll second.
We have a motion by Dan and a second by Judy. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Number two is ordinance 27-2021, authorizing the collection of administrative fee for Bedford Urban Enterprise Association. Chance.
Chance Sizemore, in this case, the president of the Bedford Urban Enterprise Association. So in front of you is an ordinance establishing a 1% fee for the Bedford Urban Enterprise Association. So there are, I'll do a quick bit of history. Some of you may not know the BUEA, as well as others. So the urban enterprise zones are a state established district that allow companies to receive additional tax benefits inside of those. As part of being inside of that, and receiving those benefits, they are required to pay fees to the local organization, which is the Bedford Urban Enterprise Association. Historically, when they first were created, a 1% fee was given to the state of Indiana. State law changed, that fee then transferred to the IEDC, so the Indiana Economic Development Corporation, who took over the processes that the state was doing. A few years ago, they stopped doing that and transferred those administrative responsibilities to the state association, which is AIEZ, so the Association of Enterprise or Association of Indiana Enterprise Zones. So when they changed that legislation, there were a technical issue that caused what was being practiced not to actually be following the code. So what this does is authorizes the Urban Enterprise Association to continue to collect that 1% fee, and then that fee, in our case, would be transferred upon the budget of the state association, which does all the data collection for us, puts together spreadsheets, ensures that we are in our companies are in compliance with the state association. So on the company side, it won't be any different than already practice, as well as on the local side. We still receive that 35%, that 1%. This just fixes that clerical error and allows that 1% fee to be continued. A lot of words and a lot of acronyms. Questions?
Chief, is this what you've talked about having a lifetime, lifetime expiration or this?
So the BUEA does expire. It has a charter, I believe, through December 31st of 2023. And then upon that charter, in the last legislative cycle, the state of Indiana did allow enterprise zones who are currently operating to continue operating, but solely on a local benefit level. I've had conversations with the mayor about what that means and what it could do. I did have a conversation with the state. They would not allow any new zone to be created, but it would allow the continuation of an existing zone in some manner. So ultimately, it will be up to this body at that time, whether you continue in its current situation, or have tweaks, or let it lapse. And I can go into further detail as to the economic benefit for, against, and what it could mean, shrinking it or adjusting the areas that it represents currently.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Second.
Motion by Larry, second by Angel. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Aye. Or opposed. All right, I would entertain a second passage.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Motion by Dan, a second by Ryan. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. So at this time, I want to back up to number one. I moved on to number two a minute ago and didn't ask for a second passage. So we'll go back to ordinance 26-2021, meaning ordinance 20-2021, the salary ordinance, and I would ask for a second motion for the reading.
I'll make the motion. Ordinance 26-2021, amending ordinance 2020-21, salary ordinance.
Second.
Okay. Motion by Judy and a second by Brad. All those in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay. So,
Mayor, is there a reason we need to go ahead and pass that?
I mean, we've got it scheduled for the December meeting also. It won't go into effect till first of the year.
Okay.
So I anticipated we'd follow protocol and just finish it up in December, and then it'll be in effect for January 1.
Just want to make sure that we're not holding anything up on payroll.
No, everything should be fine. Okay. That's everything on the agenda. Does the board have any discussion?
I want to thank Debbie. All these ordinances that have been coming out and all of the passages we've been making, she's been very good about sending them to us on email and letting us read it at our own leisure, and I really appreciate that. I'm sure the other council members do as well. So thank you very much, Debbie. I appreciate that. That's all, Mr. Mayor. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. The red brick, of course, basically falls under the park board, but they have started, I believe, hanging drywall out there. So they're moving right along. Hopefully, maybe they're a little bit ahead of schedule. So hopefully, finally, things are starting to shape up out there, and hopefully we'll have that ready to go here. It'll be the very near future, but in the future we'll have it ready to go and back for rentals and maybe we'll use it and go from there. It's been a very long, drawn-out affair, unfortunately, for everyone, especially with COVID playing part of the role in it, and the other part being an historic building like it is. Other than that, I know it was mentioned the other day of some pavement up on N Street by Breckenridge. There's a section up there that hasn't been finished, and we did N Street. That section was left open because we've been trying to work with the utility company, and I believe it's a center point now, is supposed to be going through there and tearing all that out. Unfortunately, of course, they're running behind schedule, so I'm not sure exactly when that's going to take place, but that's why that wasn't done, was if we paid, they were going to get ready they thought sooner than what they have now, they were going to get rid of it back out. So they're supposed to do their, whatever they're going to do at that area, and they're supposed to pave it and take care of it and go from there. So if that's all, then I would entertain a motion to adjourn. Motion by Judy, second by Amy. All those in favor, signify by aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Thank you very much.